After months of tension in Sudan, fight erupted 2 days ago between the army and a powerful paramilitary force known as the Rapid Support Forces. The clashes have trapped several Ugandans in the capital city of Khartoum, including 19 travelers who were transiting to Mecca. They are currently held at Sudan Airport.
A number of those are Muslim faithfuls who had gone and were on transit. And some had already even put on the spiritual attire, thinking that they would pass Mikat before the airport land. Mikat is the area where actually you have to change dress before you go and get involved in the Muslim rituals in Saudi Arabia, in Makkah.
The opposition in parliament, led by the shadow minister of foreign affairs, Muwada Nkunyinji, has addressed the press at parliament and calls on the government to rescue trapped Ugandans before the situation in Sudan gets worse.
We urge the Ugandan regime, through the Minister of Foreign Affairs and our mission in Khartoum or Sudan, to immediately initiate diplomatic measures of rescuing the thousands of Ugandan nationals caught up by the Sudan conflict.
Legislators noted that they have received several distress calls from Ugandans who are currently stranded in the field. The opposition blames the Ministry of Foreign Affairs for failure to issue timely travel advice to Ugandans.
We have not on record seen any travel advice, security advice, given to Ugandan nationals in Sudan by our Foreign Affairs Ministry, by Uganda government, or by our embassies in Sudan. This is absurd. We condemn it in the strongest terms possible.
Most countries have made plans how they can rescue their people. We've had Kenya, Ghana, and Rwanda. They are even planning to send their money and their planes to see that their people are rescued.
The opposition in parliament further tasks the Minister of Foreign Affairs to coordinate with Uganda's embassy in Sudan to verify the actual number of Ugandans trapped in the war-torn country and also allow access to the embassy. They also appeal to the fighting forces to avoid infringing on the human rights of civilians.
We finally urge the conflicting sides in Sudan to avoid any form of human rights violation and ensure protection of lives of innocent people, the citizens. We are equally echoing out our concern that the conflicting sides should avoid causing humanitarian damage.
However, Dr. Rashid Yahya Semudu, Uganda's ambassador to Khartoum, who spoke to the members of parliament on phone, has assured the public that all Ugandans in Khartoum are safe despite the crossfire. He explains that Uganda has 80 students and 120 workers in Khartoum who are all safe as of now.
We've been following up the situation with all the, our citizens who are here. I appreciate your concern about to the Ugandans who are stuck in Khartoum, the 19 Ugandans who were traveling to Jeddah to perform their Umrah. Yeah, we are in contact with them.
The story has been filed by Fred Kajubi from Parliament for the news.